him. This place is absolutely still in an uproar. And why wouldn't it be? A championship game for the ages. A finish that will be played and replayed and replayed time and again. Ernie Johnson, Clark Fellow, Vinny the Jet Smith, Charles Barkley. Who wants the first crack at it?
That's what I'm talking about. Unbelievable.
Oh, man. Awesome. Obviously, one of the greatest basketball games we've ever been affiliated with, probably in the history of the sport, the finals. The one thing that was impressive was shot after shot, play after play. It was who was going to get the last possession, won the game. Unbelievable last second play. I understand why the Carolina Bigs guard the paint. I thought that Ryan did a great job of penetrating, and it gave the illusion that Barry didn't have him under control. So they sucked in the paint, allowed Jenkins to get a three. And the other thing about the connection between the teams, Nate and Jenkins being brothers. Jenkins and Bryce Johnson playing on the same AAU team when they were 11. All of these guys have such a close fit. So I know it hurts even more when you have your brother beat you in a game.
You know what's interesting, Ernie? We call these stats out there. They, most of the time, they bet themselves out. Just look at the stats. Carolina never got an open court. No fast break point. Zero fast break points. But this is the big one. Only two second chance points. Villanova did a fantastic job of switching up their defenses. They played a terrific game and deserved to win.
And it turns out they didn't need to be within single digits in the rebounding department. It was 36-23.
Yeah, but it certainly wasn't a dominating Carolina performance on the board.
Just the second chance points were the key.
Yeah.
They just couldn't get definitely on the offensive board.
And they missed so many down
scores
at one stretch.
Yeah, because they weren't dominating block 16-2, but they just couldn't finish after they got the rebound.
I want to tip my hat to the Villanova defense. We talked about it at the top. Could Villanova apply enough pressure to negate the size advantage that Carolina would have? And they did, because that ball was not able to get inside nearly as directly or as easily as Carolina would have liked to have it get in. And when it did get in there, they missed some shots. But Villanova's defense for the body of the game, particularly the second half, was absolutely outstanding in making it tough for Carolina to run effective offense in the half court.
Clark, you watch that game from courtside. You've been doing radio when you're not doing TV, and you're calling those games. What are you seeing from that perspective there about what Villanova brings night in, night out on the intensity scale?
Well, the contagious intensity is something I've talked about since the tournament started with this team. It's a credit to their character and how close they are as a group. And then they execute. They sit down, get their bodies in the guys. They did a great job fronting the bigger guys when they switched, and the ball pressure was fantastic in terms of making it tough for the ball handlers to handle or pass it.
Much more to come from Charles and Kenny and Clark as our post-game show continues. Now, the celebration continues, and a time that we all look forward to is approaching as well. For 6 years now, it has been an honor for all of us.